For today's video, we'll be taking a look at a productivity-oriented mini PC by ASUS, the ExpertCenter PN54, powered by AMD's new Krackan Point Ryzen AI 300 series of processors and featuring a whole bunch of AI-optimized features. The PN54 is the successor to the ExpertCenter PN53 mini PC that I reviewed back in February 2023. Let's unbox it and put it through some benchmarks to see if it's any good. Now, given that the ExpertCenter PN54 is a product that is targeted at the productivity and enterprise crowd, it's unsurprising to see that ASUS has gone with a run-of-the-mill appearance for the packaging, where it features a black and grey colourway. Let's take a quick look at the specs of the ExpertCenter PN54 review unit that I was sent for this video, the PN54S70036NL. As far as I can tell, this part number could be for media samples, and it should be identical in terms of specs to the PN54S70033NL model that's available to purchase in Singapore. The review sample that I have here comes equipped with a mid-range AMD Ryzen AI 7-350 mobile processor, which is an 8-core part with multi-threading, where we get 4 Zen 5 cores that have a max boost clock of up to 5 GHz and 4 Zen 5C cores that have a max boost clock of up to 3.5 GHz. The processor also comes with integrated graphics, that is, AMD's Radeon 860M that features 8 CUs and is built on the RDNA 3.5 architecture. The PC also comes with two 16GB sticks of Samsung DDR5 5600 SODIMM RAMs for a total of 32GB of RAM, and storage-wise, the ExpertCenter PN54 has a WDSN5000S 1TB SSD pre-installed. Audio is powered by a Realtek ALC3251 audio codec, where we get a built-in microphone and speaker. While for your internet connectivity needs, we've got a MediaTek MT7925B22M Wi-Fi 7 module that supports up to the 160MHz channel width and also comes with built-in Bluetooth 5.4 support, as well as dual 2.5Gb Ethernet ports. We do also get the following I/O ports with the ExpertCenter PN54. I'll run through the mini PC's connectivity in detail later on in this video. And with that, let's take a look at the contents of the box. First up, we have the mini PC in a cloth bag, which is unexpected. I'd have thought that it would come shipped in a plastic bag. I guess this is for eco-friendly reasons. Setting aside the mini PC and the cardboard dividers for now, we get a 120W power brick with corresponding power cable. And this is accompanied by a VESA mounting kit comprising of a VESA mounting bracket that is to be secured to the rear of your monitor and these two packs of screws, like so. Moving on, we also get a safety information booklet. A regulatory information leaflet. A guide on how to install the VESA mounting kit, as well as a warranty information booklet. Taking a closer look at the ExpertCenter PN54, it has a pretty compact footprint with the dimensions that you can see on the screen. It has an exterior chassis that's constructed entirely of plastic, with a matte finish for the top and bottom, along with some vertical stripes in a glossy finish that wrap around the short edge of the mini PC for some visual interest. The front panel's pretty straightforward, where we get a power button, front panel connectors, and a co-pilot button along with an ASUS logo. On the left side of the mini PC, we get ventilation openings. Ditto that for the right side, where we do get a Kensington lock slot in the bottom right-hand corner. The top panel of the ExpertCenter PN54 has a fingerprint sensor And over on the bottom of the mini PC, we get lots of little square ventilation openings and four round rubber feet. Also visible are the two screw holes that are to be used for visa mounting purposes, as well as a latch and lock that are used for service access purposes. In terms of front I/O, we get a power button, a 3.5mm audio combo jack, two USB 10Gbps Type-A ports, a USB 10Gbps Type-C port, as well as a co-pilot button. As for the rear I/O, the ExpertCenter PN54 comes with a USB 4 Type-C port that supports DisplayPort video output and power delivery. We do also get two DisplayPort 1.4 ports, dual 2.5 gigabit Ethernet ports, a USB 2.0 Type-A port, a USB 10Gbps Type-A port, a HDMI 2.1 port, as well as a port for the mini PC's power adapter. In case you're wondering, the PN54 supports up to four simultaneous 4K displays, with the maximum resolution supported as per the table on the screen. For service access, the PN54 features a chassis with a toolless design, and gaining access to the insides involves undoing the bottom cover lock like so, and thereafter sliding the spring-loaded release button to the left so as to unlatch the bottom cover, and thereafter you can lift it away from the chassis. Right, so here's the motherboard of the ExpertCenter PN54 in full view. First up, we've got the two DDR5 SODIMM slots that the mini PC comes with right here, where they are pre-populated with two Samsung 16GB DDR5 5600 SODIMM modules for a total of 32GB of RAM. We've got a rectangular shroud of some sort. I can't quite tell what material it's made of, but I'm guessing it's probably used as a heatsink of sorts. As of the time of publishing this review, the ExpertCenter PN54 supports a maximum of 64GB of RAM, that is, two 32GB sticks of RAM. Beneath the RAM slots, we can see the two PCIe 4.0 X4 M.2 slots that the mini PC comes with, of which this slot here is populated by the pre-installed WD-SN5000S 1TB NVMe SSD that comes with the PN54 as standard. According to WD's specs sheet, the SN5000 has read speeds of up to 6000 MB per second, write speeds of up to 5400 MB per second, and utilizes QLC NAND flash. The other M.2 slot, which is a PCIe 4.0 X4 slot, is empty and available for you to install a second drive where needed. It's worth noting that we do get two thermal pads for the M.2 slots on the lid of the PN54 like so, which is great. Now, removing and replacing the pre-installed M.2 drives, pretty straightforward. All you've got to do is to undo the retention latch like so, and this releases the M.2 drive from the slot. Reinstalling the drive is pretty easy too. Just insert it back into the slot, and thereafter push down on the retention latch, and that's that. Easy peasy. While we're still on the topic of M.2 slots, the MediaTek MT7925B22M Wi-Fi 7 module can be found right next to the RAM slots, where it utilizes the M.2 Key-E form factor. This means that in future, you can swap out the module for something newer, say a Wi-Fi 8 module when they're released. And with that, here's a recap on the specs of the ExpertCenter PN54, where it's pretty much a PC that's ready to go out of the box with Windows 11 Pro pre-installed. In terms of power profiles, over in the BIOS, we can see that the PN54 comes with a default Balance Enabled power mode that can't be changed. And for fan control modes, we've got three to choose from: Whisper, Standard, and Performance. For the purposes of testing the PN54, I'll be using the stock Standard fan control mode. To put the mini PC through its paces, I'll first be running 7-Zip's compression and decompression test, Cinebench 2024, Cinebench R23, and Geekbench 6.5, so as to test the productivity performance of the Ryzen AI 7 350 processor. I'll also be running Geekbench AI to get a sensing of the processor's AI chops. Thereafter, to get a sensing on gaming performance, I'll also be running the in-game benchmark tests of Black Myth Wukong, Cyberpunk 2077, F1 23, as well as Shadow of the Tomb Raider at 1080p. Finally, I'll also be running CrystalDiskMark so as to check on the performance of the included WD-SN5000S M.2 SSD. Let's get started. With the benchmark performance data out of the way, let's take a look at thermals and power draw. The following results were obtained via Hardware Info 64's sensor readouts while running F123's in-game benchmark for around 9 minutes in a non-air conditioned room with an ambient temperature of around 31.7 degrees Celsius. As can be seen from the results on the screen, the Ryzen AI 7 350 processor achieved an average CPU package temperature of 89.9 degrees Celsius, where it hit a maximum temperature of 93.8 degrees Celsius during benchmarking. CPU package power draw was around 53.7 watts during the benchmark, with a maximum power draw of 55.1 watts. While running Cinebench 2024's multi-core test, the Ryzen AI 7 350 processor achieved an average CPU package temperature of 92.5 degrees Celsius, where it hit a maximum temperature of 100.4 degrees Celsius during benchmarking. CPU package power draw was around 46.6 watts during the benchmark, with a maximum power draw of 63.2 watts. The idle thermal and power draw figures are as per what you see on the screen. The Ryzen AI 7 350 had an average idle temperature of 43.9 degrees Celsius, while drawing an average of 3.8 watts of power when idle. A brief note on acoustics, the ExpertCenter PN54 was definitely audible under load, but not annoyingly so in my opinion. In a room with around 46.9 decibels of ambient noise levels, my decibel meter recorded 47 decibels of noise when the PN54 was idle, and 49.1 decibels of noise when under a typical gaming workload. To sum up, the ASUS ExpertCenter PN54 seems to be a pretty capable mini PC offering that should excel decently well at productivity as well as some AI-related tasks, given the performance of its Ryzen AI 7 350 processor. The cherry on top of the icing, the integrated Radeon 860M graphics is pretty capable for an iGPU solution, where it can game at, I suppose, somewhat passable frame rates on the 1080p resolution on low to medium-ish quality settings. You can even squeeze out some additional performance if you're intending to use upscaling wizardry such as FSR. Build quality is decent enough, given that it has pretty much a full plastic chassis, and we get a good assortment of connectivity and I/O options with support for up to 4 concurrent 4K displays. I think thermal performance could have been better. At least the Ryzen AI 7 350 processor didn't break 100 degrees Celsius when under a gaming workload, though it did go beyond 100 degrees Celsius at times when running Cinebench 2024's multi-core test, which I guess isn't surprising at all. As of the time of publishing this video, the ExpertCenter PN54 variant that is powered by the Ryzen AI 7 350 processor is available to purchase from the official ASUS web store for a price of $1,799. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.